This is five types of economic class. Each one of them represents the amount of money which person in each class owes. This structure is usually named wealth pyramid. So, if you never heard about it, or if you heard a very, very little about it, stay with me and smash the like button and subscribe to this channel because it has very good quality. It will be a very important video in which I will share some very important information about wealth pyramid. So, stay with me. Hello subscriber, welcome back to my video. In this video I will talk about wealth pyramid. So, give me just a moment. So, here it is. I will put it here. Okay, it's all right. So, as you can see, I put together five economic classes in this wealth pyramid that I can show you. Five economic classes are pretty much same in this, in every country in the world. This is more specific in country to country, but in general, this five steps pyramid can be applicable in every country. As you can see, my pyramid is a little bit different. Some of them maybe heard about some pyramid in high school and college, but there is one little problem with all of this pyramid. It's outdated, guys. It's from 60, 70 years of last century. And what do you think? So this is very, very old idea, and war from these ages are changes a lot today. Now it's whole different world. So let's start with me. Let's make this stuff very clearly at the beginning. I'm not some super rich, not even rich person. I'm just normal guy which find himself between bare minimum and hope to go to true middle. Just give me a bit time and I will be in the true middle. So for now I just show you some knowledge that I collect at this point at my life. So for now we're gonna look at WICO wealth pyramid and explain five types of economic classes here. So we are starting all in the debt here. That means that you have more debt than liabilities. So practically you are in negative. You are in negative. So what do you think who is here in the bottom? There is every student which graduated from college with student debt and without parents helping or some scholarship, some sports scholarship or scholarship cause good grades or something else. Some other things. Do you know who is there, of course? Some people can think about, but it is people that work, that have okay job, that bring money every day in his household, but they just spend too much. They have student loan, they have home loan, car loan, and even the debt on credit card. So they earn a little money or good money, but they spend all of his money, even more, and find themselves on the bottom of this pyramid in negative status. In the other words, they are stacked in the rat race, because when you very, very deep in debt, it's very hard to dig yourself out of this very, very big hole. So let's move on. And the second steps is bare minimum. What is bare minimum? People who works at minimum wage, but they don't go in debt, but they spend all of his money. They are practically at zero. Some of them might be on government assistance for food, for house, and for maybe someone else for their children. But it's very important that these people at zero. They are not in debt. If you look at debt and minimum, you maybe think that this debt is better, but these people maybe earn a little bit less money, but they are control their expenses and their clothes every month on zero. So let's move on at third steps on WICO wealth pyramid. third place at this pyramid. It's true middle. This is true middle, not fake middle, some middle class people hole in debt. This is true middle. So let's move on. This is the people who can afford to invest some money at people who have more equity than debt. So it can be people that pay off or owe or their house. They can have some stocks. They can have some real estate property, and they can have some good job which bring more money every month in their household. These are people who put 10 to 15% every month for investing of his overall budget, overall monthly budget. So in the other hand, there's people who go out for dinner for $100 and it's not the end of the world. They can afford it. So there is some very, very important thing. These people know a little bit about investing. Don't get me wrong, they are not some expert investors, but they know what is liabilities, what is asset, and usually by less liability and more asset. That is the reason why they are more equity than debt. And last, these people have okay job with which can afford to put some money aside every month for investing. In the fourth place of this wealth pyramid is 2%. This is people which have about $500,000 in the network or maybe more. These people have a minimum 10K every month for investing and earn every year about 300 to 400 and even more dollars. These guys can be usually some executive in some company or of mid-size company. So for them, people like this in fourth place usually manage money from people in true middle or and bare minimum. So they are managed with this money, and this is the way how they earn their money. So at the last we have B, which represent the billionaire, the true billionaire. These people are massively healthy. There is about 2,000 or 3,000 these people in the entire world, and they can afford practically everything. They can buy mansion in LA, in Miami, in Europe, and this is practically no problem for them. These people are at whole new level. So you practically ask yourself who this people is. This is Jeff Bezos, owner of Amazon. This is Warren Buffett, Berkshire Hathaway. This is Elon Musk, Tesla, and others. This guy primarily owns some very, very big business company. So others example are some people that inherit some money. It is good example for Steve Jobs' widow. She's inherit all of Steve Jobs' money, and she's practically a billionaire. She is in this club right here. So let's go next. You think who is others people that is billionaire? It is some big hedge fund manager which manage others people money. Don't get me wrong, they are not invest. They are good investors, but primarily they're not as good investor as they are good at managing others people money. They can pick some good stocks, which is good for hedge fund, but in the end they are more skillful in collect others people money, and with this skill they can become millionaire. So for now, let's take a look at this wealth pyramid. So if you are in debt right here, you have to ask yourself how much money you spend, and you have control your expenses to make yourself out of this hole, this big debt. So maybe you think that these people which are bare minimum less worthy than these people which are in debt but earn more money. But if you look closely at these people right here, they are in negative. They are negative guys and spend more than that they can earn every month. So if you just graduated from college, you have some degree which can speed your curve to go out of debt. So that can speed your curve to go from debt to bare minimum. And if you, in my opinion, if you can go to from bare minimum to true middle, the best chance, which I think, is start some business. You can start some business and or you can make some better job. But some very important thing, if you are educated enough to earn okay money, you have to control your expenses. It's not all about making money. It's about how much money you can keep in period of 1 month. Because if you earn, I don't know, for example, 100K and you spend all 100K in 1 year or even in 1 month, you are practically at zero. So it's not about how much you can earn, it's more about how much you can keep. So if you can go from true middle to this 2%, there is, in my opinion, two or three examples. First example is high pay job. You can become a lawyer or doctor or something else, but you have to put about 10 years of education, and from the beginning you are whole in debt. You are in very, very big debt, but at the end you repay this debt because you will have very, very good paycheck. So other way is become some executive. But there is some very, very problem in this. Just one people tell you that you can go up or you can go down. So if one people does not like you, what for whatever reason it is, you just don't get promotion. And the third way, it is the business. It is simple. In business, when some people don't like you, you can go to others. When other people don't like you, you can go next. You always can go next, but if you some company, when this your people, when your boss don't like you, it is very, very bad problem. Let's go to the top. Maybe some people who watch this video are on top, but you are probably not. And come on, guys, don't lie to me. Just don't lie to me. Just be honest with yourself. There is some very, very good example, people like Warren Buffett, like Jeff Bezos, Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, they all started from something like here or here in true middle or 2%. They started here, guys, and then step by step climb to the top. So it is very important for me. So for them, in my opinion, the best way to climb yourself up in the wealth pyramid is go into entrepreneurship, go some business. When you go in some corporate, you can make sure that all people likes you. Because if just one of them don't like you and this is your boss, you never go up. And in business, in one people don't like you just go to the next and next and next. And it is not easy, but at the end you can collect some people that like you, that like your business and product, and that can make you climb up with the wealth pyramid. So anyway, I hope you like this video. In this video, this is just my opinion, and if you came across this video right now, smash the like button, leave the subscribe, because we have very, very good content. We have two videos per week, which is highly educated, and it can help to learn more about investing money and some others similar stuff. So for now, if you want, leave the comment where you in this wealth pyramid and where you want to be in 1 or 2 years. So this is it for now. We will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching and have a good day. Thank you. Enjoy.